Hi there, Josh here with Evergreen Tutorials, and today I'm going to show you how to use the EDATE function in Excel 2016. First thing we're going to want to do is just try it out. Go into a given cell, type EDATE equals EDATE, left parenthesis, start date. So now we want to put in a slash formatted date, so 04/12/2018, comma, how many months after this date do we want returned to us? So we want 3 months after. And it gives us the result of 91. What went wrong here? Well, with the date, we want to put it in quotes. If we don't put it in quotes, Excel will see 3/12/2018. That doesn't quite make sense. So now with the quotes, 3 months after the fourth month is what? Another thing. You have to format it as date now. And we can see that 3 months after 4/12 is 7/12. Great, we're getting progress here. The start date can be formatted in one of three ways. As a quoted string, as a serial number, as we just seen. The serial number is the days after January 1st, 1900. And we have another date format. And this is separated by dashes and actually has the month in text here. So 14 August 1997, it'll accept that argument. Now I'm going to show you a use of EDATE that we can use in our spreadsheets. So I have a business and I hired a bunch of people this year and I have to give them evaluations 30 days and 90 days after they started. So what I can do with EDATE is equals EDATE, left parenthesis, select this will reference that data, so it will constantly be looking back at that, comma, 1 month after they started, and I get that unformatted date, and I want to put that into short date, and I know that on 5/26/2018 I will give the first evaluation for link. I can select the small green square at the bottom right of that cell and drag it all the way down to complete the rest of my data. And the pound bars, that just says there's too much data to display. I make the cell width bigger and it shows that data. Now second eval, I know that it's 90 days. Now instead of referencing the first date, I can actually type in equals EDATE, this one, comma, 2. So 30 plus 60 is going to equal 90, my desired result. And again, I get that unstructured data. I want to format it with a date format. Drag that down. More pound signs, make that a little bit bigger. And there we go. I now have the evaluation schedule for my business. I'm Josh here with Evergreen Tutorials, and we went over the EDATE function. If you have any questions about how to use this function or how to incorporate it into your spreadsheets, please leave a comment below, and I'll be sure to get back to you. If you like this video, you should subscribe for more content. Thanks for your time and have a good day.